Hey guys, so I just wanted to casually talk to you guys about meal planning because I've been getting tons of questions and comments about my meal planner and how to meal plan and how it's beneficial for your family. You gonna go eat your dinner in the kitchen? So first let me show you my meal planner. If you haven't seen, I do grocery hauls every single week, and in my grocery haul at the end, I show you my meal plan for the week. So this is my meal planner. My husband got it for me at Staples. You can get these online. You can get them at a bookstore or a office supply store. You can even just get a plain notebook at the Dollar Tree and just fill it in yourself. It's super easy. But I mean, honestly, he probably spent way too much on this book. It probably wasn't even on sale, but he did it all on his own. But the cool thing about it is that it has options for breakfast and lunch, which is awesome. And having a cute book, I feel like, makes you more compelled to actually fill it out because it looks nice. I don't know. I feel like I'm more organized in it because of this than if I just had a blank piece of paper. But it has breakfast and lunch options, which I usually just put out what our options are for the week for breakfast and lunch. And necessarily, I don't have to have, just because it says Thursday cereal, doesn't mean I have to have cereal on Thursday. But these are my options for the week, and sometimes we'll switch them around. So if in the morning I don't feel like cereal, I'll see what other things do we have. Oh, we have muffins. I'll have muffins instead. So it's not really set in stone, especially for breakfast and lunch. You can move it around. On the other side, I have dinner and snacks. And again, these would just be the snacks that we have available for the week. We don't necessarily have to have it that day. Or sometimes, let's say spaghetti doesn't sound good today, so we'll switch it for this day and we'll have something else that day. So sometimes we'll switch the dinners around, but basically, those are the dinners for the week. Sometimes we switch them around on different days if we're not feeling it. It's not set in stone. But the way it helps you is it keeps you, well, there's lots of different ways it helps you. But the top reasons that meal planning saves you money is, number one, it keeps you out of the drive-thru. So a lot of times, if you're hungry, if you haven't planned anything out, then maybe you didn't pull anything out of the freezer, or you don't have all of the ingredients that you need, or you're not sure what sounds good, so you start thinking about things that sound good. And when I start thinking about things that sound good, I don't think about pasta at home or grilled cheese. I start thinking about In-N-Out and Panda Express and things that probably are going to cost me a lot more money than what's already in my fridge. So it keeps you out of the drive-thru, definitely, because you have things to eat and you have them written out, kind of like a menu of choices for your week, which is awesome. Another thing that it does is it keeps you out of the store. So that's number two of how meal planning saves you money, is it keeps you out of the store. Sometimes when you are at your fridge and you're trying to figure out what you want to eat, you say, this sounds good, but you're missing an ingredient. So you have to run to the store for one thing. And if you're like me, you end up getting a bunch of things because things are marketed towards you when you walk into the store. You see things that are on sale. You see things that look good, especially if you're hungry. So meal planning definitely helps because you already have everything that you need for that week. You don't have to go back to the store because you're missing an ingredient, and that keeps you from purchasing more things that you don't need. And then another thing that it does is, number three, it helps food not go to waste. Sometimes when you're shopping, if you're just picking up things that sound good, you might forget to eat them because you just put them in your fridge and you forget they're there because you don't have a plan. Or by the time you get to it, it's not good anymore. So having a plan is super helpful. A lot of times when I go to the grocery store, I already have looked at the ad for the week and the sales. So I already make my meal plan for that week. If I do see something that's special marked down, I will pick it up, but I'll just add that to next week's plan and have it in the freezer. Or sometimes I'll cross out what I had planned and put the new thing there. But having a plan definitely saves you a lot of stress and anxiety from that day when you're trying to decide what to eat or feed your family. It's a lot healthier because you're making the majority of your meals at home, and it saves you a lot of time because you're not constantly having to go to the store. You already have everything set that you're going to make. So my next thing is to tell you some tips on how to have a successful meal plan, how to do it successfully. So now you know why to have a meal plan. It saves you money, it saves you time, it saves you stress, it's more healthy for you. Now I'm going to tell you how to do it successfully. So a lot of people don't like meal planning because they think it can be boring because you're constantly eating at home. So while this is true, you are eating at home a lot, especially if you don't like to cook. It does save you so much money eating at home versus eating out. But you do want to have time for yourself to eat out. We do eat out once a week on Sundays for lunch. We do eat out. But the rest of the time we eat at home, unless it's a special occasion. So eating at home is just so much healthier and cost efficient. So in order to make it more exciting when you're eating at home is to get your family involved in your meal plan. So ask your kids, what do they want to eat for dinner one night? Or maybe they want to suggest something like hot dogs, something simple. Or maybe they're like, oh, I want barbecue ribs. Yeah, if you go out for barbecue ribs, it's going to cost a lot of money. But if you make it at home and keep an eye out for sales, it's going to be a lot cheaper to make it yourself at home. Let's say my husband is like really craving pulled pork sandwiches or burgers or something. I can make it at home and make it healthier and make it more affordable by cooking it myself and being in control of the ingredients, and it gets your family involved. Homemade pizzas are like a great thing to have on your meal plan because the family can make it all together. And who doesn't like pizza? Who doesn't like pizza? Everybody likes pizza. So getting your family involved in mimicking recipes. There are so many recipes, copycat recipes that you can make online. If I'm craving Chinese food or if I really want to go to Panda Express, I can make my own and I can make it at a fraction of the cost. I can make it enough to feed my whole family for the price of what it would have cost to feed myself. So definitely getting your family involved is going to be making for a successful meal planning journey for you because they're going to be on board because you're making these fun treats for them. Another thing you're going to need to do to have successful meal planning is to set a budget. So if you don't know what your budget is, you need to keep track of how much you spend on food. Every time you go to the store, every time you go fast food, every time you go order pizza or go to a restaurant, add that up for a couple of weeks if you don't want to do a whole month. Add it up for 2 weeks and then multiply it by two, and that's how much you're spending on food for a month. A lot of people don't realize how much money they're spending on food in a month. It is crazy, especially if you go to restaurants a lot. You're spending a lot of money. Also, just all those runs to Starbucks, all the $2 in the vending machine and $4 at the gas station and $5 at McDonald's. I mean, all of these things add up really quickly, especially if multiple people in your house are doing this. So keep that in mind. Setting a budget is take that number that you realize you spend in a month on groceries and food and cut it down. So maybe just take $100 off or $200 off. Cut it in half. I mean, cut it down slowly at first, and then if you manage the next month to do better and to meet that new budget, and you did it easily, maybe cut it again the next month. So that way, I like having a budget lower than what I can afford. So that way, if I go over, it's not that big of a deal. I try to live within my means to where I cut my budget even lower. Because let's say you realize you're spending like $600 or $700 a month on food, which is super easy to do if you're going out to restaurants a lot. If you cut it down to $600 or $500, you just cut it down slowly, that extra money can go towards things that are fun for you. They can go to family vacations or savings or a down payment for a car. I mean, new clothes for yourself, new cosmetics, new makeup. That money can go somewhere fun instead of just eating it. Like, we eat so much money, it's crazy. So now we have gotten our family of four budget down to $300 a month for groceries, plus every Sunday for lunch we go out to eat. Hold on 1 second, I have to fix the fight. Okay, sorry, my kids were fighting. But so yeah, definitely lower your budget, spend less money than you were spending, and that's always a good idea to start with. The next thing to do to have a successful meal plan in the means of saving money is to use similar ingredients. So what I like to do is go with what's on sale. Let's say corn is on sale. I'll try to incorporate corn in multiple recipes in the week. Or bell peppers are on sale. So maybe we'll have stuffed bell peppers one night, and then the next night maybe we'll have pasta and I'll cut up bell peppers and put it in the pasta. And then the next night maybe we'll have fajitas. So you're having the same kind of ingredients, but you're using them in different ways to make it interesting, or you'll put a meal in between and separate the bell pepper ingredients by like one different thing And then like bell pepper ingredient, different ingredient, bell pepper ingredient. So every other day you have something with bell peppers, if that makes sense. The less ingredients you're purchasing at the store, the more money you're gonna save. So when you're using a whole bunch of ingredients for one recipe, that's like 10 things you need to buy just for one meal, plus all your other meals. So what I like to do is not only am I buying less ingredients because that means you're spending less money, is I try to keep it only to one interesting, complicated recipe per week. So you'll see on my meal plans that most of my recipes or meal plans for the week are super easy. Like, let me just look. Turkey burgers, spaghetti, fried rice, like simple meals. And then I'll have like one complicated meal per week that I need to buy multiple ingredients for, like chicken and biscuits. Like maybe that's something I need to buy multiple ingredients for. So I'll have that be my extensive recipe of the week. And then the other recipes will be super simple, like chicken and green beans, Caesar salad and pizza, quesadillas and watermelon, like super simple meals. I also have like having one night a week where we have leftovers, or we'll do leftovers for lunch. But I like having one night a week where we have leftovers, usually in the middle of the week, because that is gonna save money, because we don't have to cook 7 nights a week. And then, or the second to last thing is to plan easy meals for busy nights. If you know that day you have a lot going on, plan a freezer meal or an easy meal for you to do for that night. So that will keep you from going out and buying food and having something simple at home for you to make. So those are just some tips. I'm trying to think if I'm missing anything. Let me see. Similar ingredients, less ingredients, one complicated recipe a week, set a budget, get your family involved, plan special treats, and easy meals on busy nights and a leftover night. I think that's everything. If you have any questions about meal planning, how to do it, how to make it successful, how to set a budget, how to grocery shop efficiently, just watch my grocery hauls. You can also always leave a comment below or direct message me on Instagram. I try to check those frequently, and I usually always reply to my comments the most that I can. So thank you for watching. Don't miss any of my grocery haul videos. I always have my meal plan there, and I help you to buy groceries and plan meals on a budget. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys next time for a money-saving video. Bye.